everyone, this is Chandrasekhar welcoming you all to the India's largest and the best live learning platform, that is GridUp. So you guys are watching me live through the session called Achievers Corner. Actually, in this session we bring the successful students who had cleared the examination, so to share their success story as well as giving you the valuable suggestions so that you can improve your strategy. Those who are appearing for the competitive examination, in the near future, they can improve their strategy. They can plan accordingly. So in today's session, we are having Mr. Yatish Kumar along with us, who had secured All India rank 325 in GATE 2021 in mechanical engineering. So we hope his experience will definitely guide you, motivate you, inspire you to crack your examination with flying colors. So first of all, I welcome Yatish to the session.
Thank you sir.
So Yatish, let us start with the beginning. What inspired you to appear for the GATE examination? How your journey had started for this examination?
Sir, actually, I came to know about GATE examination second year of BTech. So I started my preparation in third year, second semester actually. So at that time, I did some self-study and given my GATE exam in final year for the first time. And I got just 50 marks in that. So I was not satisfied with that. So I want to take an year gap again and joined the GridUp for the online coaching. And again, this year I got the 325 rank. So my main motivation was to join PSU.
Okay.
For getting a good job.
Yes, all right. And you have done your graduation from which college? Tell us something about yourself.
My full name is Bhogata Yatish Kumar. And I belong to Rajahmundry in Andhra Pradesh. And I have done my BTech in Mechanical Engineering from Shastra University in Tamil Nadu. Mm-hmm. In 2020. And this was my second attempt in 2021.
Okay. All right. So actually, in our belief, your success is multifold, because you have cracked this examination in such a bad situation because of this COVID-19. Everywhere there is negativity, there is demotivation. It is difficult for the students to concentrate on their studies. Yes, so you might have faced these type of challenges. How you had overcome these situations? COVID, did it played a role in your journey? How it affected your preparation?
Sir, actually, this corona doesn't have much effect on my preparation, because GridUp is completely online mode. Mm-hmm. So I just have to sit in my room and just click on the GridUp app and just watch the videos. Mm-hmm. So that's not a big problem for me. But one thing happened is where I came to home from Chennai. So at that time, I have to be in quarantine for 10 days while the course is going on. So that was a big break for me. For 10 days, and after that, to cope up with the course again, it took me around 1 month. Mm-hmm. So watching the recorded videos and doing all the quizzes, so it took me 1 month, and again I cope up with the course and just continued with the flow. Mm-hmm. The schedule was given by GridUp, no, so I just followed the schedule of the GridUp.
Okay. So you had been the regular student of GridUp, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Which batch you had joined?
Target batch, sir. Target batch 2021.
Target 2021. All right. So in your opinion, for cracking this examination, this prestigious examination like GATE, how much time will be required for completing the syllabus and getting the rank in single or two-digit rank? So is it the number of hours which is important, and what is more important? Share your experience about that.
Sir, actually, quality is more important than quantity. So not studying for 10 hours or 12 hours per day, but studying for 4 or 5 hours per day with good concentration will produce more good results. So I think with the proper coaching, 6 months to 7 months is sufficient enough to get a good rank. Actually, I was also thinking of getting below 100, but just because of some silly mistakes, I ended up getting 300 rank.
So would you like to suggest anything to the students to avoid those silly mistakes? Because it is a very common problem. Most of the students keep on asking us how to avoid the silly mistake. But they would love to hear from you because you have experienced at the ground level these situations. So how you try to overcome these situations?
So actually, to avoid silly mistakes, there is one thing: to practice more number of questions, more number of different questions and good questions. So, and also read the question properly from first point to last point, because in the last point you will be getting all those means what the units they are asking, whether they are asking magnitude or absolute value. So all those things plays a crucial role. And also get used to that virtual calculator of the GATE. So whatever you practice, practice in that virtual calculator. So that will be helping you a lot.
So you had appeared in GATE examination twice, right?
Yes, sir. This is my second attempt.
Second attempt. And the pattern was changed this year. Yes, MSQ inclusion was there, as well as you were given a chance to opt two subjects or two branches. So was that a pressure to you that the pattern had changed? What was the role of inclusion of MSQs in your preparation?
Yes, sir. Actually, MSQs brought some changes in my preparation. So I joined that MSQ series by GradeUp, that 1 month series. And I regularly used to attend that series. And I just got to know some how to tackle with those questions. But and also in the test series, I used to come across those type of questions. But ultimately, in the final exam, there was not even one question from MSQ.
But there was a pressure, right?
There was a pressure, sir.
In first attempt, your strategy would have been different, and in second attempt, it would have been different, right?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the right strategy to prepare for the examination, in your opinion? How to utilize the daily routine to the maximum level? How you ensure that your daily schedule is utilized in a more efficient manner?
So, daily revise the things that you're already the previous day you have studied, so revise those things in the next day, and also do the questions, practice the questions of this topic along with that daily videos, and daily used to give the test quizzes that was provided by GradeUp. And I also used to scroll down the GradeUp app, where there will be a lot of quizzes means posted by many other peers. So I used to do those things, and I just practice more number of questions, and that's the main main technique to crack this gate. Practice more number of questions.
The more and more you practice, the more and more you will be comfortable. So everything is related with the practice, I believe, right?
Yes, sir.
If you want to improve your speed, practice more and more questions. If you want to avoid the silly mistakes, practice more and more questions. If you want to become more and more confident,
yes, sir, practice more number of questions.
More number of questions. So the bottom line is, in GATE examination, it is all about practicing more and more questions, yes, rather than revising theory more often. Is it?
Yeah. Actually,
how did you manage to revise the theory? Because some people are asking, sir, shall we revise the one subject at a time, or multiple subjects should be revised? How to optimize the revision part?
So actually, I used to revise once in every 2 months, so in this 2 months, around 1 or 2 subjects will be getting completed. So I used to revise those 2 subjects at a straight shot, like for 4 or 5
parallelly times. Yeah, parallelly, you used to revise 2 subjects. Okay.
Means while during the preparation, my main focus was on practicing the questions only. I shifted to revision only just 2 or 3 months before the exam. Means it got completed in October. So from November onwards, I used to revise very rigorously every day. Means I think I've done more than 7 to 8 times the revision of entire syllabus.
Okay.
Yeah, revising in the last 3 months is very important.
very important. But how to optimize the revision? Did you make your own notes, short notes, or what about the formula list? Because so many students are asking that formula, we are not able to memorize the formula. There are a lot of formulas in mechanical engineering. So how did you manage to revise the syllabus? Is there any strategy for short notes or how to memorize the formula? What was your strategy about that?
Actually, I made the running notes along with the class of the grade up. So I didn't make any short notes for that. My running notes is very short, and why to make it more concise. So I every time I used to revise from that notes itself. Mm-hmm. And as a formulas in the running notes itself, I used to highlight those formulas with the boxes or some radium colors. So I just used to highlight those things, and whenever I used to revise these things, those things used to catch my eyes. So mm-hmm. I used to read it more frequently.
Okay. But you were having a single notebook for a particular subject.
Yes,
no separate formula list. No special attention for the formula. Means some people write down the formula, all the formula in a single place, try to paste on the wall, try to memorize. Is it required or the one single running note? But the notes were yours only, right?
Yeah,
yes, sir. Your handwritten notes.
Yeah, yes, sir.
That is important, right?
It's more important, sir. Mm-hmm. Not downloading any other notes and reading those things, sir. We have to be studying your own handwritten notes. Then only it will be effective. So I think that handwritten notes is enough, sir. There is no need to make short notes. But the formula notes, it depends on individuals, sir. Means if they have enough patience and practice, means enough time, they can write that formula notes. But in my case, I didn't write those things, sir. Just one short, one notes is enough for me.
Mm-hmm. And one more thing, Yatish, because you have appeared, you have prepared for your examination through online mode.
Yes, sir.
But when people start attending the classes online,
yes, sir,
two things come to their mind. One is whether they should attend the classes live or they can how to utilize the recorded format. Or they should skip the live classes, better to watch the recordings. And one more thing, two questions I am going to ask you. One is the how to manage or how to gain maximum out of these online classes. And one more thing, when you are in online mode, there is a very high chance that you can start surfing the social media, or you can distraction is the biggest hurdle in online mode. So what is your opinion about that? What would you suggest to the students?
So as far as possible, try to attend the live lectures. Means unless it is very important to skip the lectures, don't skip the lectures, because in the live lectures we have the interaction with the faculty. Means you can ask the questions directly. And means you can be in the flow with the schedule that was prepared by the respective institute. Mm-hmm. If you keep on going for recording, you should have your own schedule. Means that may not work always. Means they will be providing the quizzes after each classes. So if you go with that, it will be more effective, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. And
yes. Second part. Social media distraction. How to manage that? Should we completely boycott the social media, or how should we make a fine balance?
No, sir. We no need to completely boycott that social media. Means just attend the classes in laptop. Means in the laptop you won't be getting those Instagram or WhatsApp, those things. Just try to keep the phone away while you are watching the classes. And after the class, because in WhatsApp, you will be sharing the document, PDFs and all. Means that is also very important. Means we cannot completely boycott those things. And since it is an online course, you should have that accessibility to social media also. Means, you will be providing some groups where we all join and we discuss the questions. So and all. So it's not suggested to completely boycott the social media. But try to balance, maintain a proper balance between the preparation and that social media. Try to spend as much less amount of time as possible in social media.
Mm-hmm. One last question I would like to ask you, Yatish. what was the role of GradeUp in your preparation? Means how much credit do you want to give to GradeUp?
Yes, sir. The GradeUp helped me very means in clearing the subjects, means clarifying the topics and all. And also it provide used to provide a very means more number of quizzes for each and every topic and part tests and full length tests. So I think from GradeUp itself I have solved more than 5,000 questions means in the entire preparation. So that is a very good thing. Means we don't get much more questions from everywhere, whereas GradeUp is providing more number of questions. Mm-hmm. And there are other people who can post the quizzes in the app, and we can access that. Mm-hmm. And we can check our ranks among our among our peers, so where we stand in that exam. Mm-hmm. So all those things helped me in practicing more number of questions. Mm-hmm. And also analyzing my mistakes and going forward.
Did you appear for the mock test also, and how is it is helpful in the preparation?
Yes, sir. I have attended a mock test. I think 3 mock tests were conducted by GradeUp. Mm-hmm. So I have attended all those things. And every time, I mean, whenever I used to see the result, I was getting above 80. So that gives me a confidence. And also when seeing my rank, I used to get under 20 in all those three tests. So that used to give me a confidence. And I also get to know in how much time I am completing the exam. That is also very much important. Means you have 3 hours exam, you have to utilize each and every minute, but I used to complete within 2.5 hours while giving the mock test. Mm-hmm. Yeah, means that gives a confidence while going to the exam. So time is not at all a constraint, just need to be cool and calm. Mm-hmm. So those things you'll be getting while giving the mock tests.
Sure. Yes, mock tests are important. It is kind of rehearsal to your final exam.
Sir.
Once you appear in mock test, then you become more comfortable, more confident, more calm and composed. Yes, definitely, I do agree with your point. And what are your future plans?
Sir, as of now, I'm waiting for the PSU recruitments and I have applied for the IITs for MTech. Mm-hmm. So I will join MTech and I will parallelly do the job trials. If any PSUs come, I will attend those interviews.
Okay, so what is your ultimate objective? Would you like to join the PSU or would you like to do the MTech from IITs?
My aim is to join PSU only, sir. Mm-hmm. But in the present situation, so there are not many recruitments happening. So I just opted for MTech. And if any PSU recruitments come, I will attend those interviews as well, parallelly. And if I get that, I will go to the PSU, depending on the job, means what kind of job I'm getting there. So I'll go there.
All right, Yatish. Okay, Yatish. So it was very nice talking to you. And in the last, I would like to thank you for giving us your time, your valuable suggestions, your success journey, sharing your success journey. So that is going to be beneficial for the students who are going to appear for the upcoming examination. And at the same time, I would like to wish you all the best from my entire family, GradeUp, for your future endeavors. And in the last, because students definitely love to hear from you guys who had already appeared for the examination, you are really inspiration to those students. You have achieved this success in the very negative situation, very drastic situation. So you are definitely an inspiration to the students. So one final advice, would you like to give to the young generation, the younger aspirants? So then we will close the session for today.
Yeah. So these are very tough situations for everyone. You just need to have a positive mindset. Means if you allow negativity, then it will completely destroy your mind in these times. So just be positive and make short-term goals, not very long-term, like 1 or 2 years. Just make in this week, I have to complete this much. So in the next week, I will complete another. So ultimately, these things will accumulate and ultimately you will reach the goal. So that's the main thing. And as far as grade is concerned, the practice more number of questions and do revisions. That's it, sir.
All right. Thank you, Atish. Practice more number of questions, okay. Be positive and make the short-term plans. These are the highlights for the day which Yatish had given us. I hope you have enjoyed the session. Stay tuned for the next one, because grade up ke saath sahi prep hai to life set hai. Thank you very much. Thank you, Yatish, once again. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.